Welcome to Bite Size Science, brought to you by the American Chemical Society, the world's largest scientific society. I'm Adam Dolevsky.
Oh, that smells good. Oh, that's awful.
For almost 25 years, chemists and other scientists have tried to build a machine that can do exactly that. They want an electronic nose that can take a whiff of the air, food, or other objects and say whether the odor is nasty or nice. Such a machine could work in factories and help tell whether food is fresh. An electronic nose could also sniff for harmful air pollutants. And unlike people, it could work 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, without getting tired. A German scientist named Udo Wiemer and his team decided to look into how much progress has been made towards the electronic nose in the last 25 years. It's not an easy task. Odors are really complicated. The next time you eat, notice the aroma arising off your plate. That smell is made up of hundreds or even thousands of chemicals that float through the air and into your nose. For example, it takes more than 1,000 chemicals to make up the rich, deep aroma of coffee. Those chemicals land on millions of special cells in your nose. Those cells have the amazing ability to change the chemicals into nerve signals. They send a message to the brain, which figures out whether your food smells fantastic or funky.
Ugh.
Dr. Wiemer found out that electronic noses are pretty good at sniffing out certain chemicals, especially a few that humans can't smell at all. Carbon monoxide is a great example. Humans can't smell this poisonous gas, so an electronic nose could help warn people before they get ill. Electronic noses could also help sniff out bombs by detecting certain explosive chemicals. However, present-day e-noses can't detect nearly as many important smells as humans, dogs, and other animals can. So while today's electronic snouts can't stop and smell the roses like we do, they may help keep us safer. That's it for this bite-sized science video podcast. For the American Chemical Society, I'm Adam Dolevsky.